Hey everybody, RockPaperMario here, and welcome to the sun-drenched tropical Luca, City of Luca, here in Final Fantasy X. In the last part, we pretty much just hitched a ride on the SS Winnow from Killica over here. And we pretty much got to see, I was going to say a load of assholes arrive here as well, but the Killica beasts are cool. I've got to say, I kind of appreciate the Luca goers for their sass as well. And then Tide is pretty much just like trash talk, so. You should be all caught up right now. Don't you shush me. Bite my shiny metal ass, Waka. There's like these weird instrument people. I don't know what's up with them, they're just weird. I guess it's like their way of like being able to carry the instruments around with them wherever they go. Behold the abacus. Behold the blabacus. I don't know why I thought of that all of a sudden for no reason.
That's a guado, right?
Who could it be?
Isn't that Maester Seymour?
Seymour Butts is what it is. Well, Luca, I made it, despite your directions. No, actually, it's not even him that, like, says that line in the thing, so I don't know why I'm saying that. Come on, Titus, do it. You've got to fit in. Ah, there's the real deal. It's that one guy that we met in Shenmue 2, that Master Yoda guy, is who it looks like.
People of Spear, I thank you for your generous welcome.
Hey, no, don't mention it.
And all of you as well. I present to you the son of Maester Jiskel Guado, who departed for the far plain a fortnight past. As some of you already know, he has been officially ordained a Maester of Yevon.
Oh, he came to life. Good for him. What's up with like...
I am Seymour Guado. I am honored to receive the title of Maester. In life, my father Jiskel worked to foster friendship between man and Guado. I vow to carry on his legacy and to fulfill my duties as Maester to the best of my abilities.
Seems like a nice guy, if you ask me. It's like crazy, because like...
Bow your head.
It's like every game has like a every LP I do has a Maximilian Pegasus, and I don't even have to work with this one. The game just does it for me. It's like if ever there was a Maximilian Pegasus character, it was this guy. Was this gonna be like a big fish situation? Time will stop between them.
Really psychs you up, yeah?
Yeah, really gets your blood rushing to certain parts of your body. Anyway, can we get our heads in the game now, Waka? You know what they say? Well, no, I only just saved. I was only at a save point. Alright, loser. I mean, teammates. We've got to give them... Looks like they're kind of down in the dumps as it is.
Where's Waka?
He's at home, washing his tights.
We had to play the Gores in the first match last year.
The year before that, and the one before that, too.
Well, we would have lost to anyone anyway.
Oh, poor Keepa.
Waka.
We're playing the Albed Sykes first. If we win, we're in the finals.
What? How does that work?
That's right. We got seeded. Two wins, and we're the champions.
I don't know how any of this stuff works, so...
First things first. Let's go over the basics again, boys.
Oh god. I should have known this was coming. Moving, action, command. Do you know what? There's really not even any point in me looking at the tutorial. I'm not gonna win anyway. Not unless the game decides to just hand it to me. Yeah, that's how I feel you, Titus. That's how I'd feel if I went through that whole tutorial too.
Someone said they saw Sir Orin in a cafe.
Hmm?
Orin?
What's he doing here?
Sir Orin. Let's go find him.
Sounds like a plan. Like, in a cafe. I can just imagine that guy sitting down in a cafe which is with a soft white.
Hey!
Or a soft
hey!
White, a flat white, a soft white.
The game starts like real soon. Come back quick, yeah?
Don't worry, I'll be there.
Hey, I'll be back.
You'll be dead.
Yeah, okay.
Hey, Waka. You're stiff, man. No, not your face. Just breathe out.
not your face. You get sprung. Wanna pull up on, because you know those buns are stuffed. Yeah, do pelvic thrusts. That'll help you with your stiffy.
Maybe now we can find Sir Jack.
No one wants to find that guy but you.
How?
Sir Orin was also my father's guardian.
What?
So, he might know where Sir Jack is.
I should just, like, start
what's
inserting, like, that shocked Waka face.
It didn't
face.
Occur to me to think that the Orin Yuna was talking about and the one that I knew from Xanarkand could be two different people.
Well, in all fairness, how
I don't
many...
know why. But I knew it was the same guy. I knew it was the same Orin.
How many different guys named Orin are there, do you know, that you could be mixing him up with? Now, there's actually, like, quite a few... There's, like, two Albed Primers in Luca. And I can never remember, like, one of them is in one of these locker rooms, but there are actually, like, several of these locker rooms that you can find, so... I'm actually not sure whether this is even the correct one. I have like a strange feeling that actually this isn't the locker room where it is. I think it's actually in one of the other locker rooms. Yeah, mad summoner.
Hey! Albed Sykes, right? Some Albed saved me the other day and...
Yeah, they were pretty cool guys.
Riku gave me food and...
Aww.
You don't understand me, do you?
He's just such a kind of like a refreshingly naive character, you know?
Anyway. If you meet Riku, tell her thanks for me. Oh, and as for the first game, may the best team win.
Like, I think with Tidus as a character, like a lot of the people that hate on him and rag on him or whatever... Like, they seem to, like, focus on, like, a select few different moments in the game without, like, giving due credit to all the other scenes in the game where he shows that he has good character, like that scene right there. And maybe the Albed Primer is actually down here, you see, that's what I'm thinking. Because I know there's two, one of them is over in the theater or whatever, which is, like, a place you might never even... There it is, see, it's right there on the ground. Hello. Volume 6. In which V is revealed to be F. Yeah, I'm just here cruising in the other guy's locker room is what it is. Look, we've got another Ronso here. Don't underestimate Ronso's skill. Do you know what? If I play my cards right, I'm not ever going to do any Blitzball anyway. Well, except that one match that you have to do. At least we got the Albed Primer anyway. That's pretty much what I'm here for. That's what he's there. Well, no, that's not where I want to go. Don't ask me to know my way around Luca, because I'm never going to know my way around Luca. It's like you come back here, like, so relatively rarely. Do you know what I meant to do? I meant to, like, look up. That's actually quite useful. Thanks, Owaka. Got any weapons? We've got the... Do you know what? I'm going to stick with the Psyche. Slow touch. Thunder Spear, Piercing, and Lightning Strike. That could actually be quite useful. Even though, like, Sensor is actually really useful as well, so I'm gonna stick with this. No, not worth... Well, no, MP plus 5%. And the Red Armlet. Do you know what? I actually have one of those. I don't know why I haven't equipped it on him yet. Magic Bangle, MP plus... Do you know what? I'm actually good at the moment.
The people here gotta love Blitz.
Do you know what I could do, actually? I could be, like, selling... the the things that I don't need, because you get so much of this crap. Like that. I don't need that, even though it did have sentimental value, technically. I don't need that. I don't need that. Like, I don't need any of this crap, really, to be honest. And, like, you get so many, like... You get so many weapons. Bright bangles. See, that's... See, the thing is, like, that... That, like, deflects darkness or whatever, or makes it less likely for you to... To get hit with darkness or whatever. Like, these sell for, like, good money. Like, 387. It's like... You're really, like, bringing up your guild. And the Belladonna wants the Poison Touch. Just by the same token, like... There's no point in having some, like, attack... Some weapon that has, like, a physical... See, there's the Red Armlet. Fire Ward, Ice Ward, Lightning Ward, Twilight Steel. I'm gonna hang on to that just in case I decide... To change my mind. And you know what? I might as well buy that magic bangle. She's got nothing better at the moment as it is, so then I can go and sell the regular one for all of 12 gil. Like, that's gonna make such a difference. I'm actually meant to go and, like, find out how much gil you're supposed to lend him. We will have, like, plenty of time to go do that. What you do want to come down here, though, which you could be, like, forgiven for not even bothering coming down here, is you want to come down and, like, have a... Ooh, that's actually quite good as well. Equip... Kamari, I meant to equip you with this. Yeah, that's okay. I have too much HP as it is. Sensor and piercing and water strike. Do you want that could be like somewhat useful? Do you want I'll put it on him for the moment? What was I even saying? Oh yeah, you could be forgiven for like not even realizing that you have to like come down here. Well, not that you have to, that's the whole point, is that you don't have to, but if you do go down there, you'll be rewarded handsomely with gil and a tidal spear for Kamari. And there are, like, multiple places like this that you can come down here and you could find anything. There's actually quite a few treasure chests, which are really quite easy to miss, but I mean, two Phoenix Downs at, like, a point in the game where Yuna doesn't have, the Rise spell or Raise spell or whatever it's called in this game, Life, probably. It's like, I remember, it's like, that's the thing, there are so many, like, different translations over the years of Final Fantasy terminology, they all end up getting mixed up in your head. It's like, Espers, Aeons, Eidolons, it's like, where do you even begin with that conversation? Okay, so we're still down here at the harbor, there's, like, more of those Guado guys. So basically, we're already being introduced to the fact that there are, like, several different races at play here in Spira. You've got, like, the regular Spearin people, I guess what they are. Like, the Humes is what they would be in Final Fantasy XII terminology. Sorry for, like, wasting all you guys' time, like, wandering around down here. The Humes is what they'd be in, like, the Final Fantasy XII terminology. And then you've got the Albed, and you've also got, like, the Guado already. And they're pretty much, like, they're pretty much going to be, like, the three main races at play. And you've already got kind of, like, hints that, like, there's so obviously some reason why the Albed are kind of a bit testy when it comes to us. And, like, they're kind of not exactly the most friendly folk. You have the Ronso as well. I forgot about them. How could I? Our very own Kamari being one of them. So, yeah. I don't know at what point I'm gonna, like, it's such, like, a tough decision to make, like, where to end off the videos in this LP, because it's, like, you want to avoid there being, like, a 25-minute video all the time, but then I guess people will watch it, I guess. At the end of the day, if it makes more sense for the storyline to do that, then that's what you're gonna do, isn't it, really? Yeah, Tidus isn't used to doing all this work. As I say, though, I think as a character, like, the people who rag on him so much, they have a habit of, like, focusing on a couple of small little parts of the game instead of, like, focusing on all the points where he shows that he has good character.
Please let me through.
Like...
Hey, let's go.
like that point there where he was talking to the Albed and was pretty much just being thankful for them to the Albed in general for helping him.
Really famous.
Yeah, that's Lord Braska's daughter. It's like you can never have enough big white it's like big white belts, Helga. It's like if you were to beat Beeper King's daughter, you'd be famous too. Or like a lot of the points where like where he's just genuinely very supportive and nice to Yuna.
What was that?
Or to the Aurochs as well in general.
Xanarkin, we do this to cheer on Blitz players.
Teach us how to blitzle or whistle, I guess. Or give a little whistle.
You try it too. Put your fingers in your mouth like this.
Like this?
Aww.
Like that. This.
I like how they changed the voice acting there. It's
then
just so fun.
You just blow.
Give a little whistle. Give a little whistle. And
it's
always let your Tidus be your
practice.
Guide.
Okay.
That's where you're going to get to Carnegie Hall, Yuna.
Then I'll come running, okay? Well, guess we should just stick together then. Until you can do it.
Aww.
Yes, sir.
Aww. At least he gives her something to be happy about is the most important thing, I guess. Okay, note to self. One of the things I have to look up is how much gil I want to lend to Owaka, because I really like him. And it does have like an impact on what stuff you can buy from him later and how much it is.
Whoa.
Or some shit.
This is a pretty big town.
Luca is the second largest city in Spira.
I thought every town was little, you know, like Besaid and Kilika.
Yeah, because they keep getting trashed by Sin.
Towns don't usually get bigger than that.
See?
Because when a lot of people start to gather...
Sin?
Bingo!
What about Luca? It's safe here?
It's not any different, but the stadium is here. The Crusaders fight to protect it with all their strength.
They protect the stadium?
Blitzball is really the only entertainment that we have. Spira's a little short on fun these days.
That's why it's so refreshing to have someone like Tidus just enter in here.
Talk about pressure.
Who's so kind of, as I say, refreshingly naive.
That's right. Is Xanarkand like this too?
It's a big city.
Well, there are more buildings, all tall ones, and cramped together.
Oh.
Ooh, the Chinese fireball. Ooh.
They must be so tall. Don't you ever get dizzy?
What's so funny?
Find Sir Orin.
Yeah, stop laughing at me and let's find our Orin here. Now I guess he's supposed to be in like up here. But isn't like the way to the theater? I want to get that like Albed primer out of the way so I don't have to worry about it again pretty much. So basically to get that you're going to want to come to... Wait a second, isn't this like the exit of the area? I don't want to end up going to like the exit of the area already. 1,000 gil. Well, maybe I do. I'm pretty sure this is just the way out of Luca. Oh, it's my faves again.
What you doing here? The tournament's about to start.
I'm looking for someone.
Well, you're looking in the wrong place. There aren't many people here.
Everyone's either at the stadium or watching the game on the sphere. They love their blitzball.
Aren't you gonna watch?
No, they have to protect the stadium.
We might do, but we're waiting for some couriers.
I don't think I've ever seen that scene before.
Wanna ditch the courier and go watch the game?
But we're still on duty. What about the mission, sir?
Is it just me, or like Gata's? We might be a little like, late, can you see his crack?
You better be winning.
Oh no, that's just like the colors.
Yes, sir.
I got really confused there because if you look at like his outfit, it's like the same. There's like this big like leather patch that's like the same size as it. See, we can't leave here. That's like the same color as his skin, and I was like, wait a second, isn't his ass crack supposed to be there? And it's not. I don't think I've actually ever seen that scene before. Probably because I've never like acted like a dummy and tried to leave Luca before doing all the storyline crap that happens here before. Speaking of storyline crap, I guess it's about time to finish off the video. It feels like we did nothing, even though I guess, like, that's the thing, sometimes it feels like you did nothing, but in the grand scheme of things, you've actually done quite a lot, so I guess I'll end off there, see what happens in the next part of Let's Play Final Fantasy X, see if we can find Auron sipping his flat white in a cafe somewhere. And yeah, thanks for watching. Bye now.